Hey, Frugivore, welcome back to the Frugivore Diet Channel. So today's video, we are going to react to Lenny Kravitz. So I've followed Lenny Kravitz in the past when I was younger. I enjoyed his music. He's been around a long, long time, but I'm unsure of how he eats. But some of you actually said he was raw vegan and you wanted me to review his raw vegan fridge. So that's what we're going to do today. I'm excited to check it out because like the fact that he is vegan is fantastic and even raw vegan is like even better, obviously. So I'm definitely keen to check that out. And I'm wearing my old time kind of outfit here, so you can see from, you know, like pretty much a decade ago or 8 years ago I used to wear this. Everything still fits the same, exactly the same, haven't really changed, so that's more evidence of me, you know, just maintaining just the same kind of weight over, you know, the period of, you know, a decade nearly. So anyway, if you want to see more of these videos, give it a thumbs up or a thumbs down if you don't. Just do something if you want to see more of them. Okay, let's get into it. Let's check out what Lenny Kravitz has in his raw vegan fridge. Okay, Frugivore, here we are on the Men's Health YouTube channel and they've got a video on Lenny Kravitz showing his gym and his fridge. And we want to check out that fridge, don't we? We really want to check out that fridge in particular. Quite a few of you have been requesting this video, so I'm intrigued. The suspense is killing me. Let's get into it.
Whoa, nice Airstream.
Wow, so did he call it an Airstream? I don't know. It just looks kind of like a fancy trailer to me. That's quite like down to earth for Lenny Kravitz, like considering how wealthy he must be at this point to be living in like, you know, a fancy trailer, right?
Hey, Lenny, we're here to see your gym and fridge.
Okay. Hey, Lenny.
Hey, what's happening?
So Lenny is like 56 years old at this point. He's 56, so he's getting along in years. And he looks youthful first up. That's something that I noticed straight away. Okay, fruit and veg. Yes. Wow. Okay. Is that him now? Is that him now? Seriously? Wow. He looks amazing. Okay. Bahamas.
All right, Lenny. Oh, wow. Before you show.
Okay, so we got mangoes.
Around. Let's check out
veggies, non-sweet fruits.
All right. So here's my fridge, which has a picture of Bruce Lee on it.
Cool.
Keep me inspired.
He inspires
what
me.
We have.
So he, I mean, he's wearing big glasses, so I can't see his eyes, but he looks very youthful, 56, right? I know genetics play a part, of course, darker skin can play a part, but like he looks very youthful. That's just what I noticed.
It's green and more green.
Yeah.
We've got cucumbers, mangoes, broccoli, kale,
wow,
salad greens over here on the okay table. Fresh from the farm, we've got breadfruit, soursop, which is my favorite.
Yum.
Soursop is so good for you.
Yes.
You should try it. Sugar apples.
Wow. This is pretty awesome. This is pretty rawsome, right? Soursop, I agree. We grow them here. They're incredibly healthy. They're sweet, sour tasting. Oh, I love that. He's got breadfruit. We grow so much of it here, but I don't eat it because it's kind of weird raw. It's good, but it's kind of strange. But he probably cooks it. Sugar apples, we grow them here as well. And he's got okra, I grow that. And well, he's growing this. This is amazing. Avocado.
Lemon, some more okra, and cucumbers, avocado, some fresh rosemary.
Yeah.
Picked this morning. A great blessing of living here in the Bahamas is that I'm able to grow my own food.
This is wonderful.
So I have a garden where most of this food comes from.
Wow, this makes me very happy. Let me give you a thumbs up here. This is...
As you can see, I'm vegan.
Yes.
And primarily raw.
Wow.
I have done extensive raw diets where I eat raw for a year. When I'm
Wow. He seriously looks like he could be like 25 or something. So it's definitely working for him. And like you said, he's done extensive, you know, raw diets where he's eaten for a period of time. And he's vegan, he said, and he's primarily raw. I think this is wonderful.
That's where I eat raw. For a year. When I'm here, I love to eat as much food as possible,
yeah,
especially in the summertime when you have all of these beautiful fruits,
yeah,
growing.
Yeah.
But then there'll be times where I don't take in sugar, not even fruit sugar,
oh,
and I just eat green, you know, sautéed spinach or kale.
Okay, so you know how I feel about that one, not taking in any fruit sugar. That one came out of nowhere. I didn't expect it. I did not expect him to say that. Obviously, every cell in your body runs on glucose and fructose helps power your body as well. So you need to take it in because you're a frugivore. So this is probably just something he's heard, you know, like there's been a lot of hype around the kale. We're not even really meant to eat kale. the baby kale, okay, yeah, but a lot of people are eating this mature stuff and it's so incredibly tough. It's tough on digestion. It's just, there was a lot of marketing around kale. Did you notice that? A lot of marketing around greens. There should be more marketing around fruit. Unfortunately, there's just like a whole lot of a movement against fruit because of its sugar content, which we need it. We need the sugar. Like, seriously. So, yeah, he's just fallen for a little bit of marketing there.
Salad. I'm very careful about what I put into my body and how I take care of my body.
Yeah.
So it's a combination of eating all of these things that I've shown you. And
the problem with the greens is that you just end up fasting, essentially. You know, you don't get enough nutrition and you don't want to limit your nutrition. He said he just eats greens sometimes. It's just, it's not necessary, okay? And it's not satisfying. So don't worry about it. You can see me. I'm still fit, lean and healthy, and I pack in the fruit sugar. Lenny, you are doing great, but you need to go fruit yourself. And I recommend my Go Fruit Yourself book, of course. This shows you how to do a raw food lifestyle correctly. You know, the frugivore diet is basically outlined in this book. I am writing another book, but this is the basic outline in this book. And you can get this instantly. There's an ebook link in the description below, or the physical book, which is coming soon on Amazon. But you can get the ebook instantly, okay, and change your life starting from today, starting from this moment. You can live a new life and you can totally transform into that individual that you truly want to be. And fruit-based is the way, whether it's raw tofu or the frugivore diet. Yeah, I just highly recommend it. You just have to get the fruit in. You can't restrict fruit and just focus on greens. It's just a big mistake. And unfortunately, people like Fully Raw Christina are kind of like promoting that. You know, you see that and supplements and stuff. You know, it's not a long-term, sustainable, like affordable lifestyle. And yeah, I just want you to realize that you are a frugivore and you need a lot of fruit. And that's naturally.
Working out and keeping my muscles and my joints in shape
That's
so that
important.
I can do what I do, which is get up on stage and play music and have a body that feels free so that I can explore.
Wow. Have a body that feels free. I love that statement. I love it. And I totally agree. That is so important.
If you'd like to see where most of this food comes from, I'll take you over to the garden.
Yeah, let's go, Lenny.
Come on.
I mean, Lenny was big when I was growing up, you know, and actually even before I, like, seriously, he's been big forever.
Here we are at the garden, so come on, I'll show you around.
Okay.
Wow, sounds like paradise. You seem like such a healthy guy. Do you ever have a cheat meal?
My cheat meals consist of pasta, bread, pancakes, waffles, carbs, and more carbs.
Okay, so can you make this connection here? Can we make the connection for Lenny here? Cheat meals. So, and he said carbs, and he listed all these high carbohydrate foods. We know why, right? Because he's under eating on the sweet fruit and he's having these periods of eating a lot of greens where he's not getting enough nutrition. He is essentially fructose deficient, glucose deficient during these periods. So then he'll binge out basically. So it's always better to have the big sweet fruit meals than to go to this processed man-made food, right? It's always better, you know, with the old milled flours, grains that have been sitting around for potentially years. You know, it's always better to have that sweet, nourishing, vibrant, living fruit in you, you know, rather than waffles, like you were saying.
Bread, pancakes.
I mean, pasta, bread, pancakes, waffles. It's all very beige. You want to get in that living fruit nutrition so you avoid the beige wartime foods.
Waffles, carbs, and more carbs.
Yep. What do you eat if you're hungry at 2 a.m.?
I wouldn't eat at 2 in the morning. If I wake up and I'm hungry, I'll just drink water to fill my stomach.
Yeah, I mean, like, who would eat? What a strange question. What would you eat at 2 a.m.? Do people actually eat at 2 a.m.? Like, if you're out clubbing or something, maybe in the past I've done that, but, like, you just wake up and eat? Nah, I don't do that.
Look what we got.
Oh, wow.
Jewels.
Wow.
All right, so now that we're finished at the garden, I'm going to take you...
That's beautiful. And he's got some... Is that turmeric or carrot? I can't tell. Maybe carrot, actually. Cucumbers. Oh, sour salt, avocado. That's wonderful.
We're to the gym. So you can see where I get my workouts.
Okay, so I don't think we need to go into the gym bit, do we? We can just, like, scrub along here. Yeah, so he does strength work. That's important. That's great. You know, when it comes to strength work, I do strength on the land here. And I suggest that you find a way to get your own food forest going, growing your own food, and then you can get your strength workout without having to just, you know, you're wasting it, just kind of just pumping iron. When you can be putting it into the land, you can be planting fruit trees, you can be digging holes and putting that energy into something that is going to build a future for you rather than just looking in the mirror, posing basically most of the time. Not saying he is, but a lot of people doing that in the gym, wasting a lot of that valuable energy when it can be put into food production for yourself, for your future and your family. So, yeah. Okay, so that is a video. I'm very impressed with his raw vegan focus. Okay. He obviously needs to eat more fruit. I would love to see a massive big pile of fruit in that fridge rather than as much greens as there was. It's still great to eat greens. I recommend them as well, but you're not going to get enough nutrition if you focus on the greens over the sweet fruit, because sweet fruit is where it's at. You know, sugar is not the enemy. Even refined sugar is much better for you than having something as high in fat and processed foods. And, you know, it is refined, but it's also what your body recognizes. It still recognizes that glucose, those monosaccharides as fuel, breaks it down into glucose, and then your body uses it. It's obviously better with fiber and with the micronutrients, of course, but we need to stop seeing sugar in any other way other than it is fuel, okay? It's not like the devil. It's not a drug or anything like that. It's what every cell in our body and brains runs on. So we need a lot of it, and obviously in whole food form, that is optimal, all right? And that's what I recommend, the frugivore diet, raw to four. So yeah, I'm impressed. He just needs to go fruit himself more. I love that he's growing his own fruit. He just needs to get more in. And Lenny, I will coach you any day. Come and like hit me up. I will definitely show you how to go fruit yourself. All right. Okay, let him know we made this video for him. Don't forget to go fruit yourself, and I will see you soon.